Hey guys, this is David Kwan. In this video, I want to continue talking about Deus Ex, which is a really classic PC game. And like I said, playing this in 2013, it was a chore in the beginning, and just having to get myself used to the graphics and the mechanics that feel so aged, especially in 2013 or even in 2008, it was kind of a struggle to tolerate this game and to play through it, which is probably why it took me so long to actually get through the entire experience. But I did it. And you know, there does come a point in Deus Ex where the more I'm playing it, the more I'm realizing that this game is quite amazing. It's really a masterpiece. It's such a complex game, and you come away thinking, I came away thinking, they really don't make it, like, they don't make games like these anymore. This kind of gaming experience is so rare to find now, and it's an experience that's, you know, I don't even think the awesome sequel, not Deus Ex Invisible War, I haven't played that, but Deus Ex Human Revolution, which is definitely one of my favorite games of this generation. I really enjoyed playing that game, but even that game hasn't made me feel like, wow, this game just is just so, like, they don't make games like these anymore. This is a rare find, you know, and it's interesting because I get that feeling even though the gameplay mechanics of this game has aged so horribly. It's a chore to play through this game, especially trying to be stealthy and all that. But it really is the core concepts behind the levels, the way you start becoming better at playing the game. This is a game where you can carry all kinds of weapons and items at one time, but you fit them into the inventory slot, so it really depends on how many slots you have left. And even without upgrading that inventory slot, which I never did in my playthrough, you can still fit a lot in there. By the end of the game, I had an upgraded sniper rifle, and so these are all the items that I had with me at one time. I didn't have to, you know, change anything around. But I had an upgraded sniper rifle, which is amazing. A silent sniper rifle. I had a silent assault rifle with amazing accuracy improvement. I had a silent pistol. I had the tranquilizer dart. And I had the laser high-frequency sword, which just is so powerful. And it's amazing for stealth kills. And a whole bunch of other stuff like med packs, augmentation, the bio cells, there's a whole bunch of different grenades, because I had the EMP grenades, gas grenades, which I hardly ever use, but, and then the explosive mines. So that, I had all that at one time, and I could choose from that inventory, and that was really awesome. And in the very end, I actually switched out my sniper rifle for the Get Gun, which is ridiculous. That's because you find out, and you can find it in the very later parts of the game on the catwalk, right before you go into the lab setting, the lab that will ultimately shut down the Area 51. So yeah, I found the Get Gun with like 20 rockets. Maybe I've been accruing rockets because I've never really used a rocket since that point. That was really helpful to carry that weapon around. I didn't have any heavy weapon skill upgraded, but yeah, really cool just that you can carry all these weapons, and there's so many options in being able to tackle the situation how you want it to. I mostly played it stealthily as I can, although that gets really difficult at times because of the newer enemies that gets introduced. The Black Agents, they're a pain in the ass. You can't kill them stealthily. And you have to pass them. Sometimes I can pass by them stealthily, but most times I have to engage them. And they're a pain in the ass. Because those Black Agents, Man in Black or Woman in Black with blue hair or gray hair, that's interesting, the character design for that. Really weird and odd. But you kill one of them, when they die, they explode. So stealth kill is impossible, because if you sneak behind them and you kill them, boom, explosion, you're dead. Anyway, I kind of digressed off on the point, but I think what makes Deus Ex such a masterpiece is the level design. You know, there's so many times in the game where I'm just like, okay, I'm now infiltrated into the base. What's this air duct here? And I go into the air duct and I'm just like, oh, I could have come infiltrated this base through this air duct. And I come over here, it's like, there's a ladder here. Oh, I could have come in through this way. Oh, there's like electrified bolts. If I had, if I hacked into this console and turned electricity off, I could have come in through this way. And so figuring out all these variable paths to take in, all these options, pretty amazing. And the complex systems at work with hacking, with gunplay, with stealth, and with the upgradable abilities, I think by the time I reached the one of the later levels, but it's like almost halfway point in the game, I upgraded some of my skills and had all the augmentation canisters. So I have all these augmentation abilities, like being able to camouflage myself, being able to be invisible from surveillance devices, and being able to lift heavy items. Really cool. The options featured in this game are pretty damn amazing. And I really liked about this game was they don't do this with enemy AI in every other game. All the other games, they don't do this. But if the enemies gets damaged enough, if they're too hurt, they stop fighting you. And they're like, oh my god, I'm in pain, I need backup. And they start running away from you. And they're not worried about fighting you anymore, they're just worried about running away. I actually like that idea a lot. In execution, it can be really problematic. It's really problematic when, you know, I'm trying to conserve ammo. I have this one guy who I've hurt so much, but he's running around and I have a crowbar. And I just want to whack him just one more time to just knock him down. But no, he's running around. I'm trying to get the controls just right. Then I just keep missing him. And he's just like, whack. He runs away. Damn it. And I follow him. Whack. He runs away from me this way. Damn it. I keep missing him. That can be really annoying. But I think it's a really cool idea that, you know, if an enemy is hurt too much, the enemy is more concerned about his safety than fighting you. Great idea. Really great idea. But just gunplay could be much, you know, I mean, that's probably because I'm more used to modern shooters now. Modern shooters like Call of Duty and Battlefield, and even I think Killzone is probably the Killzone experience with, to me, is the experience that I really like the most, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3, because every bullet that you hit, you know, you can see the reaction of the enemy. You rain down bullets on the Hellgast enemy, and you can just see their blood coming out and their reactions to those hits. I love that. And the animations are different every time. If something like that was in, I don't know, this is wishful thinking, but that's probably why gunplay in Deus Ex never felt that great to me. And because it's an RPG game, I tried to not have as many gunplay as possible until I upgraded. Oh man, once I got my assault rifle upgraded and my sniper rifle upgraded, that was, gunplay started to become really easy until I start meeting enemies that are pretty ridiculous. So really, I mean, it's quite an amazing game. I guess in the next video, I'll get into much more detail and really get into spoilers of this game and just kind of talk about how I went through this game and what my overall playthrough experience was like from the beginning to the end. And that will be in the next video. So cheers till then.